Eivor, child of Varin. Eivor Wolfkissed, is that you?
Do I know you?
You were too young to remember me, but I stayed with your household many years ago. This is for you.
The Meadhorn of Suttunga. How is this possible? Can you conjure things from dreams?
Yes, it's only a model. I fashioned it from a story told to me by your father, but since he's dead, I offer it to you.
It is exactly like a sword in my head, as Varin described it to me. Have you made other things from stories?
Only if the storyteller is very good. Your father was. He would have made a good scald.
Could you do it from dreams or visions? Bring something into this world from another?
Not all dreamers speak, and fewer yet speak clearly. Seers talk too much and cloud your vision with...
What's this about bringing things into this world from another?
More like imagining it into our world. When I have the image, its design speaks to me in a language I do not know, and yet understand.
This is Suttunger's Meadhorn, Valka, from Jotunheim. Varin described it to him.
I do not like this business of trafficking in visions. But if it revives good memories of your father, there may be value in it. I will bring you a potion that will let Eivor dream and speak clearly. If you take advantage, your death will be painful.
Nah, you need not go to so much trouble. You could give me the recipe.
I will bring you a potion. Do not dig too deeply. We do not know the true cost of this.
There will be no cost to the gods. You heard him. He does not take things from their realms. He imagines them, then crafts them.
Not the cost to the gods. To you.
I will get the workshop ready. Come by when you want to get started. Eivor!
Eivor.
I would like to see what you have in stock.
You are looking.
What have you got for me?
I do.
I must be on my way. Stretch your wings, Sunan.
You'll be safe in my care. Valka has promised that any harm you suffer will be visited upon me tenfold.
She is protective of her people. But I must exact a promise from you. You must not speak of this to anyone. Whatever happens.
I swear upon my life, I will not speak of this to any but you.
When you're near, dear Raven, my memory is sharp, my aim unmuddled. Down there in Niflheim, things are less clear. You know I cannot take you. I can barely get myself through the warding wall, and only then by abandoning my trusted weapons. Do not sulk. I will not risk you, for who then would remind me of my purpose? Yes, Baldur, my son. The light of the world locked away in Hell's dark castle. He was taken too soon, stolen from us. I shall not rest till I have denied destiny and brought Baldur back from the dead. You're right, Moonin. If it is to be done, best it were done quickly. It is time to go to Hell. Niflheim's riches are doubly defended. I must kill the guards before disarming the shield.
What?
Surrounding this prize must have been tied to its defender's life or death. Going back now. Or suffers a kind of half-life. My patience has been rewarded. Shrines are known to be places of healing.
this piece.
What's going on?
No peace around here. Someone's pulled the wolf's tail.
What's going on? What? Why all the fuss? What's all that chaos?
What's all this? Huh? No peace around here. Hold there.
Never a quiet moment.
Thank you.
The King of Thieves welcomes all who wish to bargain fairly and freely.
Can I expect fair treatment from one holding so dubious a title?
I was once a common thief. Fighting over scraps, picking corpses clean of all that could be bartered or sold. But now, as their sovereign, the rogues of Niflheim trust me with their traffic. And you may do the same.
I may offer trade, but my trust is not easily earned.
Fine by me. I'm not looking to make friends, only deals. Are you interested?
Show me your stock.
Something going on?
You are mine! Thralls take you! Huh? Raven bait!
Better stay alert.
What's the fuss?
Why go to some other shop when my shop will come to you?
You carry your whole shop with you. That is quite a feat.
Anything can be negotiated if you have the means, even this difficult land. Would you like to see what I have?
Let us get down to business then.
lest I make a monument of your bones.
I granted you this realm, child, but I will unmake it if you deny me Baldur.
You gave me a barren world, filled with the dishonored and other undesirables. I gave them purpose.
What purpose? An afterlife of constant death?
No. A new kind of life. One free from the fear of death. All who serve me shall have their rebirth. Oh.
Come on.
Welcome, wanderer, to the home of Danny the Dead One. To my shame, I can't offer better hospitality. My enemy got here first.
I am not that, wanderer. I'm but a simple traveler.
Save it, Javi. I get around. At least, I used to before Durf took over my foundry, locked up my men, and cut down my ropes.
Ropes?
When I ran the foundry, I had rope lines strung all over Duckerland. That's how I moved parts so quickly, see? Ropes.
Sounds like quite an operation. Like you were building an army.
I could supply 100 armies. But what does that matter now that Durf and his paid muspels have taken everything?
Are any of these rope lines of yours still usable?
Not many. But if someone were to free my men, we could string them back up. Get you across Duckerland in no time.
Seems like a reasonable bargain. Where are your men imprisoned?
Locked inside the foundry. There are two sets of keys, each carried by a muspel.
So, if I retrieve the keys from the muspels and free your men, you will repair the rope lines.
If you free my crew, I'll take back the foundry and, by Durin, we'll tie more knots than the Nornir! Are you going to the foundry or not? My dwarves can't free themselves. No dwarves, no ropes.
This muspel has a set of keys, just as Danny said. That looks like a warrior of rank. Perhaps he carries some prize on his person.
Hospitality without a host. Are these drinks? Which one shall I choose? I will not take a drink at this time, lest it muddle my purpose. Which one shall I choose? By my loins, I feel refreshed. Only one drink per visit. Generosity has its limits.
trouble. What's going on? The needing.
Looking for a deal?
Let us get down to business, then.
What's all that about? Die, Lambert! Die! Die!
Oh!
Those must be Danny's dwarfs in the cages.
Favor you, my friend.
This way! Help!
Ah, thank you, my friend.
Over here! Help!
Odin bless you, Ravenbearer.
Looking for a deal?
Let us get down to business, then.
One of Hell's foul experiments gone awry. What shameful crime could have earned so twisted a fate?
It's not the Nornir, but you and that bitch Brynhild who made me thus. Have you betrayed so many gods, Oathbreaker, that you no longer recognize their king?
Yongun, why has Hell raised you as this? Grotesque monstrosity.
I rebuilt myself from abandoned appendages and discarded flesh. A labor of loathing, fueled by vengeance and driven by hate.
Going back now.
Just a kitchen.
Ergas, a cack.
Moment. Kenesatara. Kayakashu. Any fair or so, could you?
Bring some beef, yours.
That's an old shed.
A tour de whore.
Hodge?
Kenna Sejora. Kordjak Nichu.
Looking for a deal?
Let us get down to business, then.
No, there.
I repair these bridges, will they just fall apart?
I mean no offense, but it does seem a pointless task.
Such is life among the dead. The corruption what eats at these bridges is fed by the same hands who demand their maintenance.
And whose hands are those?
The hands of Nidhogg. A twisted collection of druids, mystics, and priests who serve the ruler of these pestilent islands.
Nidhogg. I know that name. A creature whose depravity is legendary. He reigns here?
Aye. Drinking the sap of Idris's roots, while his hands gather the living and dead for him to feast upon.
And the ones responsible for the rot that eats at these bridges. If I eliminate them, it would ease my passage through here.
Nidhogg is the true root of the rot, but cutting away his hands would slow its spread. You could start with my owner. He's a dark druid who patrols this area, dressed to inspire terror and loathing. The dark druid may be hard to spot in the mist, but his attire is unmistakable.
The air appears to shimmer here, much in the way it does when the Jotun weave their illusions. Smells like a trap.
Yes.
I shall make better use of this than Hell's officer would.
Your shop is not easy to find. That cannot be good for business.
That's to keep out the damn wolves. Not that it's had much effect. Anyway, if you're not clever enough to find my shop, you likely have nothing worth trading.
You may be right about that.
Of course I'm right. Now, are you here to do business or not?
I'm curious to see what you have.
Ah, it's the keen-eyed traveler. Looking...
I'm curious to...
lock and the droid won't detect my approach.
Fiordi!
Droid's belongings might be useful among the...
Take it! Take it!
One moment.
They filled your kitchen. Gavin, I clean you.
One moment.
Hogy?
They filled your kitchen. On Belox at
Jora!
Vasa Kak!
Looking for a deal?
Let us get down to business, then.
Thank you.